What's up, everybody? Today I'm here in Los Angeles at the Phoenix restaurant, and you guys all know this face. It's the legend, Mike Boogie. Mike, this is a beautiful place, the Phoenix, huh?
Yes, thank you. We have a gastropub here in the heart of Beverly Hills, and board games, TVs to watch sports, great food, lots of beverages. You've been known to drink a beer here once in a while.
I've in part taken in the gastro publicity of this place. Whatever that means. If it means drinking beer and eating something, I'm in. But yeah, I watch games here. I've been here plenty of times. I've played many games here.
Many Big Brother alumni come here, so when people are in town, come check us out at thephoenixla.com, and maybe you'll see your favorite Big Brother house guest.
You never know who you're going to run into.
Yeah, absolutely.
Boogie, you played three times, and you actually won. What's it feel like to be a winner in this game? I don't know why I put myself through this torture, but please. I know.
When that door opens and, you've been locked away all that time and you're the winner and
the confetti
rains,
while the confetti's raining, a tear is raining down my face.
But, it's hard, too, because you then have to go live your life, and it's hard to go do things in your everyday life that can measure up to that moment, and you're sort of constantly chasing that high in a way.
It is.
It's really hard to do, so... It was really great, and I'm glad to have done it.
Do you feel any more satisfaction it being the only All-Stars?
Yeah, there was a lot of players in that game that, I really respected. So to be put in the house with them and sort of not be taken too seriously, being in Will's shadow and being such a clown the first time I played, I really enjoyed the satisfaction of knocking out all the best players that had ever played it. And it was very satisfying.
I've never won, so it's not...
You sort of won.
I know. I took home the girl, and
You got the girl. You got the beautiful, nice girl, so you did win.
I scored a nice one.
You did.
Well, throughout the years, you didn't really find love in the house, but you found a couple bromances.
Yeah.
Who was your bigger bromance with, Dr. Will or Frank?
They're both great. Frank's awesome, and I really, really enjoyed playing with him, especially because Will chose, not to come back.
Right. So are you saying Dr. Will?
No answer.
It's
just no answer. They're both great, and it definitely was.
They're
just
both
amazing.
Bros at heart.
They're both bros. It was great bromances.
What would you tell people watching who possibly want to be on the show in the future? What would you say a possible strategy going into the house would be?
It certainly changes as the game goes on. I would say in the beginning, as you would probably agree with, is just lay back.
Try to.
Someone's self-destructing the first week, for sure. Don't play too fast, too soon. And just kind of let the game come to you. Don't get in a showmance. Don't get in a bromance.
So I got in a fight my first week. I got in a showmance.
Yeah. No good. No bueno.
Well, there you go. That's some good advice
for the
online people.
I'm trying to make him a villain now.
How? What's it? Yeah, because I kind of played the good guy role, so to speak, and you were kind of on the villain side towards the end of your season, your last season.
I wholeheartedly embraced the villain role. I think
in All Stars you were too, right? But you were kind of both. Yeah.
Definitely. I own it. The thing is like a lot of people sort of try to live an extension of their real lives, and in my real life I'm not going around being a snake and a liar but that's the name of the game, and I'm just not gonna play nice. It's a lot of money at stake, and I really actually enjoy the villain role.
Your last season was a coach's season, so you were Ian's mentor. You ever think about Ian when he kicked you out of the house? Is there any bad blood there?
Yeah, I thought that no bad blood at all. I thought it was a great moment in the history of the game, actually. If I was going to get knocked out, I would want it to be a big moment like that. And even when he voted me out, I still thought as I was walking to the interview that he was just... got bullied into voting that way.
Right.
How everybody likes to vote with each other so they feel safe going for the next week. And it was just such a great moment to actually really see it on my face and have no idea. I really had chills on my spine. So, if I'm going to go out, I want to go out with a big move. They made a fantastic alliance that stuck together, that was unbreakable. And the proof is in the pudding. They made it to the Final Four. And he won. So
you probably could have done without to get the Stephen comment, though.
Yeah, he was a little caught up in the moment, but it's okay. Everybody has to have their time, and he really played great and was a deserved winner.
All right, so Big Brother 16, you got to be excited.
Oh, yeah, baby. Another one. Tune in.
Tune in to Big Brother June 25th. That's when it premieres. Boogie, always great to see you, my man.
Absolutely. Thank you.
Thank you guys for tuning in. We'll see you soon.
Enjoy the show.